We're going to look at the page formatting tools. So we'll start off with Format, Page, and we're going to start on this Page tab. In the upper left-hand corner, we have our paper format. In our drop-down has many standard sizes of paper and envelopes, and we'll get back to doing an envelope in just a minute. First, I want to mention that we have our width and height in inches, in my case being in the US. If you need to switch that, we would go into Tools, Options, LibreOffice Writer, General, and right here our measurement unit. We would change that to centimeter, millimeter. Let's also take a moment here to note that we can change our margins by putting our arrow over that line between the shaded and the white in the ruler, and dragging that down will change our margins from the top. And again, in the middle where these dots are, we can change our margins there. And it gives us a rough idea of where they should be. Going back into our format page, we can type in the exact numbers. It gives us a little more precision here versus the sliding, which is kind of an estimate. Also on this page, we've got our landscape and portrait. The paper tray, for the most part, we want to get this from the printer settings, so we don't want to touch that. And this format register true, we kind of talked about that a little in the paragraph feature, but most of us won't need this feature. So that leaves us with format and page layout. The format is basically how you want your numbers to look if you number those pages. You've got ABC, all caps, lowercase, Roman numerals, 1, 2, 3, or none. We're going to stick with the 1, 2, 3. They won't show up unless you turn on the page numbering, and we'll show you that in a little bit. The page layout. You've got left and right, mirrored, right side only. If you want to have different margins for your left and right, if we look on only right, we've got left, right, top, bottom. Same for only left and right and left. But if we change this to mirrored, it says inner and outer. That's if we have something like a book. We might want to have our inner margins a little bit bigger. Let's crank this up a little bit. And we can see maybe we've got an extra big binder or something that we need a larger margin on the inside. So this would be for both the left and the right. And we'll explain more with the left and right a little bit later in this very topic. Now we're going to make an envelope. There's two ways to make an envelope. The first way is just changing our format of our page. And I'm going to pick a number 10 envelope. It's pretty common here in the US, so that's why I'm going to stick with it. If you don't know what number your envelope is, you can measure it and put in your width and your height. We'll also notice that I'm going to want to change my orientation to landscape. Now my margins for my return address don't look too good, so I'm going to lower this top, and I can see that moving up in my picture here. My left, I want to make a little smaller. All right, that looks pretty good. Let's use that. When I click Apply, our page now looks like an envelope. Let's type in the return address. And before I start the addressee, I want to move my paragraph indentation over to about there. From here, our envelope is complete. We can highlight this and change any font size or font style. We can do the same for our return address. Make it bigger, smaller, change the font. If we need to move our addressee more to the left or the right, we need to highlight it all, then move our paragraph indentation markers to the left or the right as needed. If we only grab one line, it will only move that one line. So we'll need to undo it and select them all. Then we can move them to the left or the right as needed. The other way to create an envelope is to go up to Insert and click on Envelope. From here, we put the addressee information and then the sender information. Now over to our right, we see a little picture of where our addressee will be and our return address. Don't worry about these database field, table, and database. We will talk about that in a future tutorial. Going over to the Format tab, we see the position of the addressee, which is 4.75 inches, and then 2.06 inches from the top, and our sender information. And we can change that at this time, or we can see how it looks and change it later. Right here is what's more important to us at the moment, is the size of the envelope. We've got a number 10, which is what we wanted, because that's what I used before. Now the next thing, do you want to insert or a new document? Inserting will just put this above our white page, and then we'll have two pages in a row. We want to go to a whole new document. Now we can see why the positioning did not matter to me too much in the dialog box. Here we've got two boxes, one with the sender information, one with the addressee information. If we click inside that box, I can highlight and change that text. I can change the format, change the font size, make it bold, make it italic. All the standard formatting tools apply. If I click on the line of this box, we see these green dots around the outside. Now I've got a four-sided arrow. When I see a four-sided arrow, that means I can move this box any way I want. Here I'm moving to the right, I'm moving it down, I'm moving it to the left and up, right back to where we started. The same thing with the addressee. If I click on that line, I get those green boxes and the four-sided arrow, which means I can move this to wherever I would like it to be. If I hover over this middle box, I can make the box smaller, I can make it bigger, but it doesn't really matter too much because this box won't be seen. Only the letters and numbers will show up on the print. I'll do a quick page preview now, and we see that there's no box. We only see what is printed out. So those are two quick ways to make an envelope.